So this is the full review of the LG QNED 99. This is an 8K mini LED TV from LG. Let's take a closer look. Don't forget to hit the red button to subscribe and give this video a thumbs up and click the notification bell to get my next video first. Thanks to LG for supplying the TV for review. We've not been asked to say anything good or bad about it, and there's a link in the description which will give you full information about this TV. Now, when we did our first look and unboxing video and setup, we gave a first impressions of this TV. And in that video, we had it on the stand, and it split opinion. I liked the stand, but many of you didn't. We talked about the thin bezels around the edge, and we'll mention that a little bit in this video. But what we've done for this video is we've had a little bit of a change, and this time we've put it on the wall. Now, we haven't spent a lot of money on the official LG gallery mount. We've just used a slimline mount of our own, and it's incredible how thin this TV is and how close to the wall it still gets. So I'm very happy with this result and don't really see the need to go for the more expensive mount. But for me and everyone that's seen this TV, having it now back against the wall really does make a difference in this room. It's a big 75-inch TV in a smallish room, as you can see, but it gives you that impact of almost like a cinema screen. And for me, I think it's the perfect size. I mentioned that in a video a few weeks ago, how 75 inches I did think was too big, not anymore. Okay, so we've been playing with this TV now for a couple of weeks. We've done pre and post calibration. What we found was SDR pre-calibration, it was quite far out. However, HDR was a lot more accurate. Our recommendation would be for normal everyday TV watching, our advice would be to go into ISF expert in a bright room. You can switch between bright or dark. I would just say that go with whatever interests you the most or whatever you prefer. Certainly for me, no matter whether it's a dark room or bright room, I like ISF bright. If you're in Dolby Vision, then you may want to choose between the two different cinema modes. The main difference between them will be the ability to turn on true motion or turn off true motion. Now, again, this tends to be down to the individual's choice. Some people are more susceptible to that almost soap opera type effect if true motion is on, and other people don't get bothered by it at all. I don't really see any bother with it, and so therefore I'm quite happy for it to be on. But if you are having a problem with it, then just change from cinema home to cinema, and then you can find that you can go in and tweak the setting yourself. Now, just as a recap, the mini LED technology is effectively thousands of mini LED bulbs giving you that incredible brightness, plus lots and lots of dimming zones to give you the darkness. So effectively you're getting what will hopefully be the inkiest blacks you'll ever see on an LCD TV, together with incredible brightness, and all of this without the worry of burn-in. Sounds good? Well, we're going to test it in just a second. What you've also got as well is the fast A9 Generation 4 processor, so that will do things like upscale content very good indeed. Let's start looking at some imagery. So as you can see in this example, we've got standard definition on the left, high definition on the right. Both look fantastic, but it's incredible how good standard definition is looking. It really is pretty close to the HD source. Now, you've heard the saying, the more you put in, the more you get out. Well, that's pretty much the same for this TV. The better the quality of the input source, whether it be 4K, 8K, whatever it is, then the TV basically just handles it better. It does a far better job. So if you're watching a lot of lower quality content, well, then you're probably not going to be the person that appreciates everything that this TV can do. However, if you're putting in good source material, if you've got a lot of 4K content, you're watching a lot of Blu-ray movies, that type of thing, then you're going to absolutely love what this TV can do, because it just excels the better the quality of the content that's thrown at it. So this TV has four HDMI 2.1 ports, all supporting 4K at 120Hz, 8K at 60Hz. This may well be the perfect gamer's TV, because you've not got the same risk of burn-in that you have on an OLED, and that for a lot of people is going to be a massive factor. Certainly, I've reviewed many LG OLEDs and other OLEDs as well, and I absolutely love them, but you can guarantee that every single time I do a video on it, I get a proportion of people saying, no thanks, not risking burn-in. And what LG may have done this time is given us a TV that gives you pretty much close to OLED performance, but without that risk of burn-in. And that is a gamer's dream. Now, it isn't all good, and I'm going to come on to some of the negatives or some of the drawbacks with this TV in just a second. But if gaming is a big part of your purchase, then, well, this could be the TV for you. New for 2021 from LG this year is Game Optimizer, and it's pretty much across the whole range of 2021 models. You press the settings button while you're in game mode, and this little control panel comes up on the screen. It gives you some basic information, but you can also change a few things. Is it a little bit gimmicky? Well, maybe just a touch, but it is good that you've got that information. What I would say though is what I like about it straight away is the easy access to different game genres. So first-person shooters, role-play games, and real-time strategy. You can literally just tweak those and switch between them very, very quickly from that dashboard. You can also make changes to things like black stabilizer, white stabilizer. You can also reduce blue light if, for instance, you're playing at night and you want to be able to sleep a little bit that night, then you can make those changes. But it's a little bit gimmicky, but I like the fact that it's there. It's definitely something which is a positive. Like with anything in life, there's pros and cons and ups and downs, and with this TV there are some downs as well. We're going to touch on those in just a second, but let's first of all talk about how this TV handles reflections. The reflection handling on this TV I think is pretty good. It's far more superior than with an OLED. Yes, you do still see a window that's directly opposite, as you can see from this image. However, it is definitely still watchable, whereas I find with my C1 OLED downstairs, it's not watchable if there is a window right behind it. But for the sake of this video and to give you a better idea of the overall look of this TV, I'm going to be closing the blind so that you get a better image of the TV itself. And boy, does that picture look absolutely fantastic when you're in a darker room. This is a really bright TV even in a bright room, but in a darker room, it looks fantastic. Now, one thing I wanted to point out that you're probably seeing is excessive blooming around that lettering. Now, in reality, you do see a degree of blooming, but it's not as emphasized as what you're seeing it on this image. My camera is emphasizing that, and you'll see that it almost like glows in and glows out. And in reality, you see a little bit of blooming, but you don't see as much. Now, this is an IPS panel, and that is one thing that you do have to accept with IPS panels. It is more susceptible to blooming. However, what you do get is far better viewing angles, and as we demonstrated on our first introduction video on this TV, it is quite incredible how wide you can get and how the picture really doesn't diminish. But with the blooming, as I said, it is a factor to some people. Certainly for me, it wasn't a deal breaker. Another thing to look out for on this type of panel is DSE, or dirty screen effect, and also screen uniformity. What I would say is that the lower the quality content that was put into the TV, like this, the more visible it was, and the better quality, well, it really wasn't visible at all. Screen uniformity was okay, not the best I've seen, but certainly not the worst. Now, a lot of people have been on the fence with this TV being a mini LED and still obviously therefore an LCD TV. However, it does an incredible job, and it's one of the best TVs that we've seen for delivering incredible black levels and also those vibrant colours without the risk of burn-in. It did a brilliant job in gaming, absolutely loved the gaming capability of it, and it also did an incredible job, remember, when we looked at the standard definition upscaling and also high definition upscaling. You have got those issues with it being an IPS panel, and some people will probably be more effective with that than others. And certainly, the lower the quality of the content, the more things like DSE comes into play. However, for the majority of people with putting good quality content through this TV, they're going to absolutely love it. The other thing, I think, is a really big factor, and that's the fact that if you are worried at all, if you're in the market and you're considering an OLED, but you're worried at all about burn-in, well then this probably takes that away from you. And the other thing that I've not mentioned but I'm going to be coming on to in my next video is about future-proofing. How long is this TV going to be on your wall or in your room? And so therefore 8K might not be relevant now, but it certainly will be in a few years' time. And therefore, getting this now just might make the perfect sense. Guys, let me know what your thoughts are. Thank you so much for watching this video. I do hope that's been helpful for you. Leave a comment and make sure you check out the link in the description, which will give you a lot more information about this TV.